Capcom presents.
Ready?
Heroes. Welcome to the Gauntlet of Gaming, where these hands are rated E for everyone. My name is Malik.
My name's John.
Brathen.
Santiago.
And ladies and gentlemen, it's Marvel, baby!
Did not think that's where we were going.
Oh, of course we have to start off like that. Because, in addition to it being the 20th anniversary of Marvel vs. Capcom 2 this year, it's also been announced that MVC 2 is going to EVO.
It's Marvel, baby!
See, even they're feeling it.
You know, love you guys.
Don't worry.
Don't know why.
You'll feel it by the end of the podcast.
You'll get on the hype. It's okay. This hype is infectious, like the coronavirus. It's airborne.
Wow.
Oh, okay. Good
luck to you guys.
Please, let's stop talking about that right now.
Oh, man.
I don't need to drink Modelo, homie.
Been in two videos now.
All right. So, before we start talking about Marvel and EVO and all this other stuff, let's first make sure that we let everybody know who we are and where we are. So, you can find us, most likely you're listening to us, on YouTube, where we post gameplay videos twice a week. You can also find our podcast being posted every other Sunday. Sunday.
We got the monster truck route.
There you go. Yeah. All right. Yes. So you can find our podcast every 2 weeks, whether it's Saturday or Sunday. It usually depends on how we're feeling throughout the week. You can find us on Facebook. We are the Gauntlet of Gaming. Mostly it's just for people who still use Facebook.
Send us messages.
I don't blow up my phone. You can also find us on Instagram at The Gauntlet of Gaming, where it's the best place to really communicate with us. That's where we post a lot of our stuff, and we're hoping to bring you more content soon. Also, if you'd like to send us images or videos or things like that, you can always send it to us on Twitter, at Twitter?
Twitter.
Twitter.
Yes.
Oh, man.
Twitter's evil brother.
Oh, gosh. The competitor.
Sounds like a thing.
Twitter.
Twitter.
Did you find someone on Twitter and you'd like to date them? Find them on Twitter. Anyways.
On our lesser known site. Weaker.
Oh, anyways. Anyways, you can send us pictures and videos over at Twitter at The Gauntlet with a 4 instead of an A. Gosh, you're so selfish.
I am.
I feel like that sometimes.
Bless you.
I'll be like that all the time. Let's go.
So yeah, if you couldn't tell from the beginning, or if you couldn't read the actual title for the video, or see the thumbnail, or literally all the red flags that were leading to it, today we're going to be talking about our dream roster for if there was a new Marvel vs. Capcom game. But before we get to our dream, let's give you the question of the day. Today's question of the day is, who do you want to see in a new Marvel vs. Capcom game? So, with that being said, dream roster for Marvel vs. Capcom, whatever they decide to call it. Because who knows at this point?
Marvel vs. Capcom Ultimate.
No, that's what I was thinking. They're going to call it Universe.
Wait, they can't call it Ultimate, because we had an Ultimate Marvel 3.
They just flipped the word?
Yeah, but they made the Ultimate was a prefix
Marvel
in that case, and now it's
Capcom
going to be a
Capcom X.
That was actually a joke,
what?
And it was bad.
Oh,
yeah.
I didn't realize that.
Everyone thought it was actually the logo for the... It was going to be Marvel X Capcom, and it was just like, let's not.
This is
not a crossover.
It's a breakup game.
Yeah.
Marvel vs. Capcom breakup.
Come to fight. So this is how we're going to break it down. The way that we're going to break it down is each of us decided to choose 5 Capcom and 5 Marvel characters that we wanted to kind of represent our desires in the game. It was actually really challenging.
So hard.
I wish the roster could have been a budget of like 60 instead of 40 characters, but...
We did some gimmies at the end.
Yeah, you get what you get. In addition to our 5 choices for Marvel and Capcom, we also have an additional 3 DLC characters for each, Marvel and for Capcom. So we're going to break it down going from person to person to person, and hopefully we can make a nice, interesting list of characters you'd like to play as in a future Marvel vs. Capcom.
In a timely manner.
As best as possible. So, Marvel... Capcom, if you're, for whatever reason, listening, These are just our suggestions. These do not reflect the popular opinion of the people who play Marvel vs. Capcom, Marvel, yep. or Capcom games. And we were just spitballing because we love these games. We love you. We want to see you prosper.
Yep.
Cool. All right. So with that being said, we're going to start off with our Capcom side. And for that, we're going to go over to John.
Yes.
So, John, you get to name the very first character that we add to our list to Marvel vs. Capcom, whatever we decide to name it.
We need to come up with a name.
Cool.
How about four?
No.
Stop.
That's too much. You're pretty good to barriers.
Marvel vs. Capcom 4 is too much.
Oh, gosh. All right, so John.
Yes.
Capcom, first character, who do you have?
Shiva Alomar? Olomar? I can't pronounce the last
name. Olimar!
Yeah.
Come on.
From Resident Evil 5.
Alright, it's cool. So we already starting out the gate with a Resident Evil representation. So, tell us why Sheva.
Because I love her.
I thought it was Sheva.
It's Sheva.
It's
Sheva.
Sheva
is Mortal Kombat.
Yeah. Sheva is a god. Sheva is your god.
Well, she's also...
Well, in this case... We found his video game crush.
There you go, yeah.
You've spotted her. Yes, I like Sheva. Playing RE5 with my older brother, I was always player 2.
Mm-hmm.
And I always played Sheva, and she was, of course, my first video game love.
Oh, well, there you go.
Yeah, so that's why I think she should be included. We had Chris. It's time for Sheva.
I'm cool with that. Kick Chris out. Hashtag kick Chris.
Kick Chris. Kick.
If Chris can punch a boulder, we can kick Chris.
Oh, that's true.
Yikes.
All right, cool. So we already got our first Capcom character. Now we have to ask, who's your Marvel character?
Oh, boy. My first Marvel character would have to be Loki.
His second video game crush.
Yeah. Don't you know? No, I've been spotted.
Now, here's the question. Now, before the podcast, we were chatting a little bit, and I held off on this question because I thought it would be a very interesting discussion point. And that's, which Loki?
Well, that's a good question. I want to go with Tom Hiddleston Loki.
Oh, okay, so you want some MCU Loki.
I want some MCU Loki who acts like comic book Loki.
Okay, so he looks hot like Tom Hiddleston.
Yeah, I want Tom Hiddleston looking.
But he's super goofy he's in the comics.
Yeah, but he's more of a trickster than he is an evil villain.
All right.
Just because I want a more anti-hero than I want a more, villainish.
Yeah. No, I get it. I think that's cool because you get, this opportunity for, illusions within fighting games.
Yeah, and I really thought about teleporting abilities with him. And I want him to do that whole gold fade like he does in the MCU. And I thought that was super clean when it came out. And I was just like, that'd be a cool ability for him to, pop up behind him, the opposing character to stab him with a staff.
That, or I could see Loki doing, a counter. So it's you hit him and then he, warps behind you and just goes, sink!
Or you hit him, it's his dummy, and then he does the stab in the back.
I think it'd be hilarious if he had a move where he turns into a snake and bites somebody.
Yes!
And references the story told in Ragnarok.
Yes.
Dude, or even the fact, you just bring in a whole bunch of that Loki mythos where he summons in Fenrir.
Yeah.
And Fenrir just goes in and just bites oh my gosh.
And he says, attack him, my son.
Yeah,
just
oh my gosh.
Story-wise.
And he turns into a horse.
Yeah.
Okay, let's not go too far into the mythos.
All right, those are my two.
All right, perfect. So we got the first Capcom and first Marvel character with Sheva and with Loki. Thank you, John. So now, back to the Capcom side, we're going to Francis.
We got another Resident Evil.
Oh gosh, it has begun.
Leon.
Oh my god, he's hot!
So you want to bring in Leon Kennedy.
Yeah.
So I'm going to ask you the same question. Which one?
I said RE4.
Okay.
Is that his jacket or his long sleeve fit?
That's his brown jacket.
The
leather jacket.
The leather.
Biker.
Yeah,
RE2 with the knife.
RE2 remake. Yeah,
Leon.
Maybe that can be an alt, alt skin.
He's beautiful.
So why Leon?
I think John answered the question.
Yeah,
beautiful. I want his hair.
I mean, and also, so for the listeners, Malik said this earlier before we started recording. Leon sort of become the face of Resident Evil.
Yeah,
I think, and I can agree. It's time for Chris to. Kicked.
Yeah. Hashtag kick Chris.
Bring Sheva. I miss
movement.
Her so much, guys.
Start the movement.
Started. Yeah.
And also, he hasn't been in any fighting games.
to my knowledge,
it'd be
you're
nice
right.
to see Leon in a fighting game.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever.
Was he not in previous?
No, he wasn't. In fact, they what
freaking
they did.
Chris.
What they did in Infinite, and this is how you know that like people got really salty is for Infinite. His we didn't get to look at it. Mm-hmm. His alt skin. Is Leon's jacket.
Wow.
Yeah.
Middle finger, man.
Yeah. They were just like, oh, you want Leon Kennedy? How about Chris killed Leon and took his jacket?
That's disrespect.
Right?
Because you have military Chris and then you have, you know, investigator Leon.
Yeah.
They're two different people.
Leon!
Oh, man. Alright, so we got some Leon Kennedy, so we get that RE4 representation.
We're gonna have more, I'm sure.
Probably.
Yeah.
Yeah. Look out for Resident Evil and Street Fighter taking over the Capcom right. side. But yeah, do you have anything else for Leon?
Not as of now.
Gotcha.
I'll say on the next one.
Okay. So, going from your Capcom then to your Marvel. Who's your Marvel first character?
Carnage.
Oh god, don't ever do that again.
He can, that's like his voice, right?
No, it's not.
That's his voice.
No.
Nintendo 64 Carnage. That was his voice.
Don't do that again.
It was like that. Was it like that, yes. I played
He does have a high pitch to him, but oh, Francis, that was like anime Carnage.
That means it's perfect.
That was like waifu Carnage.
Yeah.
No, it wasn't.
That was like Tsundere Carnage.
Yeah, I think you were too high pitched there.
Yeah.
Well, okay, you do it.
I'm not. But what do you know what I am going to do? I'm going to ask you to tell me about Carnage. Why? Why Carnage of all...
Because we always see Venom.
So?
Why not Carnage?
Point? Because Venom.
Venom's daddy, dude.
He's Venom is daddy. Dude.
I mean, I agree with you guys.
Actually, Venom literally is daddy.
Exactly.
Oh, God.
Exactly. That's why I said that.
I mean, I agree with you guys.
But
I want to see some red.
That's fair. No, I'm fair.
But, I mean, I'm not gonna judge you.
It doesn't count. It's still physically Venom. Mm-hmm. It's not physically Carnage.
I need some more psychopaths in my fighting games.
Okay. I
was Mega Man
that.
Enough
and
for
as,
you? Jeez.
And as Malik mentioned, Venom's sort of an anti-hero, but not a bad guy.
That's true. Yeah, he's becoming more of a. I would say he's becoming more of a good guy at this point.
Yeah.
Aside from
the way
fact that his host is a serial killer.
No. Venom, not Carnage.
Oh, I think I'm
right. Yeah.
I was like, Carnage is straight up a bad guy.
Oh, yeah, no,
no
he's
yeah,
the definition
sure.
of a bad guy.
He's
yeah,
the evil
sure.
of evil.
Yeah.
Yeah, we need that.
He makes
yeah.
evil look scary.
We need some villain representation in a Marvel vs. Capcom game. So, no, I think Carnage is cool. Hey, I'm not saying I don't want Carnage. I definitely want Carnage.
Definitely.
Yeah, it'd be nice to see.
His suit, like, his, like, level 3 super should be called Maximum Carnage. So, I'm, like,
That'd
all down.
Cool.
Yeah, I'm totally down for that.
Except not Woody Harrelson with the red orange wing.
No,
yeah,
that's
not.
That's the Carnage we need, and that's the Carnage we all like.
John, there's
that
a door.
So weird.
John, there's a door. Get out.
You look like Ronald McDonald in that scene. Am
I was like, please no. Just keep him bald. Like honestly.
Oh my gosh. Another thing I just thought about when it came to Carnage though is like. There's the storyline where he starts controlling a bunch of people, and it'd be a really cool stun ability where it's just like he throws like a piece of himself at someone and it just stuns them. Or like it's like kind of like how Spider-Man can shoot his webs and he can kind of wrap someone up. Instead of wrapping people up, they just temporarily become a Carnage and they just like sit there and he can just do damage. I think that would be really cool. But perfect. All right. So we got Capcom and we got that Marvel. So now we're going to come over to you, Santi. Who's your Capcom representative?
So my first pick is Sakura from the Street Fighter franchise.
Why? Did you hear the cringe in that Y, by the way? That was just the letter Y with a bunch of question marks. That wasn't W-H-Y.
Because I have a lot of fun playing as her in Marvel vs. Capcom 2. She's super broken, and it's just so much fun to play.
But I mean, but like...
And she's fun in Street Fighter 4.
But like Cammy... Like Armika, there's so many other better female characters you could choose.
Don't even come at me, you're always complaining about their character designs.
Okay, you got me. But playing Sakura in Marvel 2 was a lot of fun though. Yeah, she's pretty broken. At least from the casual perspective, she's pretty broken.
She's broken for me. It's the only character I can really get to like with.
But it's
That's why you chose her.
Yeah. You just want someone to Oh man, that's funny. But who knows? Maybe we can even get like enraged Sakura as like a level 3, where she just like goes berserker. So that'd be
interesting. You killed my baby daddy.
Oh god, what's happening to us?
Have you not seen her storyline for 5?
I have. I'm gonna go back to the reaction when you first said Sakura. But no, that's cool. I respect it. So we got that Capcom, but who's your Marvel pick?
The best Marvel pick ever.
I don't know about this.
Yeah. Miles Morales.
You have to fight me.
Okay. All right. Miles Morales. But here's the question, though.
Which suit?
Which one?
Ooh. I really like his graffiti one from Into the Spider-Verse.
Into the Spider-Verse. Yeah. I kind of like that.
Into the Spider-Verse, Miles Morales was golden.
Yeah.
I appreciate it.
Awesome.
What's up, danger?
No.
He's the best of all of us.
I have to say, like, if we're going to get a Miles Morales, though, like, if we're going to get Spider-Verse Miles Morales, they got to ditch the hoodie. They really need to. Like, I'm cool with, like, the logo being sprayed on there. Like, his entire...
His suit went without the hoodie.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah. They got to get rid of the boots,
like,
too.
Like, Miles Morales during the final fight.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's... Yeah, okay. I would agree.
Okay.
Yeah, but no, I mean, that'd be cool. But the question is, why?
Because we always get Spider-Man and Venom, but, like... There's so many other kinds of Spider-Mans that are super popular.
Mm-hmm.
Iron Spider.
Well, we have Iron Spider and Infinite.
Oh, do we?
It's an alt skin. It'd be like that sometimes.
But, like, there are plenty of Spider-Men that aren't Peter Parker that are super popular.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So, Miles Morales, given his rise in popularity, I think would be a perfect pick.
I agree. Well, I mean, Scarlet was also an alt skin type situation. For me, I'm thinking, like, no, Miles Morales would definitely be a great pick. Or, like, Gwen Stacy, Spider-Woman.
Future Spider-Man, like, is that Miguel or something? I think it's
Miguel. Oh, Miguel O'Hara? Yeah. I think any of those three, I agree with you. I think bringing in someone who's not Peter Parker, this is the great time to do that. And I'm sure some legacy people may get pissed off, but we just talked about how Carnage can have similar movesets to Spider-Man. I think it's time for us to, like... bring in something fresh, something new.
It'd be cool, because Miles Morales could still have similar movesets to Spider-Man, but you could use his invisibility,
mm-hmm.
his Venom Strike.
Yeah, so he's introducing some new movesets that can really make playing a Spider-Man character spiced up.
In that Spider-Man game that PlayStation, Sony busted out.
The Insomniac one?
Yeah. And even the Miles Morales in that one, I would definitely play. Because you didn't even have the opportunity to play as them, except for a couple of missions.
He wasn't even actually like.
No,
it was just Miles.
Hinted in the game, and I was like, give me Miles.
Yeah.
It wasn't just hinted.
He got it. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, my thing is, it's like, for me, when Miles Morales first started getting written by Brian Michael Bendis, I was like, instantly, like, I was on this. Like, I was like, I want to see more of this character.
Yeah.
And even though he came during a time where it was controversial to start switching up Marvel characters, I think he was probably one of the better characters that had, like, the title, you know, passed down onto him, because we still get Peter Parker, but we get Peter Parker and Miles Morales, and I think Miles Morales is a great character. In fact, Marvel would be making a huge mistake if they did decide to roll out a new Marvel vs. Capcom and Miles Morales was not a part of it.
Yeah,
even if it's DLC, like, I wouldn't be mad if Miles Morales was DLC, but to not have Miles Morales be a part of that, it'd be a shame.
Especially after how just amazing Into the Spider-Verse was.
Precisely.
Yeah. Like,
and how much that popularized his character in the mainstream.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a very popular movie.
Yeah.
I will say that.
We're all set of flowers.
Oh, gosh. We have to stop with references.
Okay.
They get out of hand. Funny enough, though, speaking of references, we referenced something before we even started the podcast.
Oh, yeah?
And it kind of goes into my first, not Marvel, but Capcom pick. It had to be my first pick. Like, it was my game of the year from this past year. I want to get Nero. Like, I want Nero in Marvel vs. Capcom. The hard part is the question of which one.
I mean, it's not hard. You definitely prefer DMC5 Nero over DMC4 Nero.
It's not that I prefer them. Like, I really love how Nero looks in DMC4. And maybe we can get that as, like, an alternative skin. But the gameplay of DMC5 Nero in a fighting game, I think, would be pretty awesome. Because being able to have the Devil Breakers switch up the gameplay mechanics, because it's like with Dante and with Virgil, they have different, you know, demon weapons that they're able to have at their disposal. So the thing for us is that, you know, we're able to pretty much play, you know, switch up his style, have some more fun, do some more crazy things. and I think it invites a lot of fun. And as much as I would love to see the Devilbringer as a part of his skin and have like a young Nero, I think it'd be pretty cool.
I do really like how he looks when he has like his Devil Trigger from DMC4
mm-hmm.
with like, because it's not really his real Devil Trigger, but it's like the spirit of Yamato.
Yeah, and I thought that was pretty sick. Especially how they kind of embodied that in Street Fighter V.
Yep.
I thought that was really cool. But to have his level 3 be like his actual Devil Trigger,
that'd be pretty cool.
That'd be clean, yeah.
Yeah.
F you!
Yeah!
What about your Marvel now?
Now, when it comes to my Marvel character, I listed Nero because he was like my number one. Now, when it comes to Marvel characters, there's one character who stands above all others, and that's Ultron. Like, when I talk about Marvel characters, I love talking about Ultron. Mostly because he's this character that I feel super passionate about because I feel bad for him. Like, he was given a bad deal. He was pretty much treated like he's a villain, even though he's just following the orders of the people who created him. And his playstyle at Infinite made me love the game so much. Like, crossing up with him and Dante as a duo, insanely fun.
Not when you're on the receiving end.
Yeah, I agree. That's a good pick.
But yeah. So,
wait, but which one? We're not talking MCU ever with you. I know this.
No, gosh, no. I definitely do not want to see any trace of MCU Ultron at all. I don't even want to see it as a skin.
Yeah.
Get that away from me.
Because if I remember right, out of the MCU Ultrons, you like the very first one where he was beaten, broken, and like...
Yep.
Yeah,
where like, he looked like he was a mess.
He looked like he was a mess, and you're like, "That's Ultron, not the weird facial feature,
yeah.
Botoxed Ultron."
That
for the Botox.
I mean, you're not wrong.
I mean, literally, he looked like he got a facelift at the end of that movie. Let's be honest.
That's funny. No, I probably would go with the same one that they had for Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite, because it's kind of the embodiment of the comic book Ultron, where it's just like, I am to eliminate all of humanity, and I'm like, cool, stick with that.
No expression Ultron, yeah. Best Ultron.
He's just a machine.
Yeah.
I like that, because it makes the quotes that he would say hilarious.
A lot more energized.
Yeah. So, those were my first drafts for Capcom and Marvel, so we're going to bring it back around to you, John. Who's your next Capcom pick?
My next Capcom pick would have to be Chuck Green from Dead Rising.
I love it.
Yes.
But the question is, why?
I would love to see a chainsaw pole arm in a game that involves fighting other people. Let's be honest, playing Dead Rising when I was growing up with specifically Chuck Green Dead Rising,
yeah.
I was enjoying it a lot more than Frank West
mm-hmm.
Dead Rising, because Frank West felt like a zombie game.
Yeah.
Dead Rising with Chuck Green felt like a
Which was Dead Rising 2 with Chuck Green, right?
Yeah. The mascots in it were better.
Mm-hmm.
The outfit for Chuck Green is just way cleaner.
Yeah.
And he was like a motorcyclist before the zombie apocalypse.
Mm-hmm.
And I was just like, okay. And then they continued to be a motorcycle guy throughout the game. I hope I'm saying these words right.
We don't ride motorcycles. We don't know.
I think he like became some gladiator in the game. I can't.
Yeah,
when he had to fight for
the Zombrex for his daughter.
Yeah,
yeah.
And I thought it was on motorcycles, and I cannot remember.
No, you're right. It was. It was the motorcycles that had the chainsaws.
Yeah.
On both sides. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Dude, that would be so cool.
Think of that as just like a special.
That's like his level.
Yeah.
His level 3.
Yeah.
He just kicks you up, or he like. Just keeps. Oh God.
Yeah.
And his alt skins are just him wearing the different Capcom heads.
Exactly.
There you go.
Yeah. Not like Frank West. What was that?
He had
that you showed me that had.
He had Proto Man as his outfit, and I was like, that's such
a
jab.
Like a fat Proto Man.
Yeah.
I was like, that's unnecessary.
I don't
need this.
We don't need any more references to the old cover art of Mega Man.
Thank you.
Being a big boy.
Yeah. Boy. Yeah, I would choose Chuck Green.
Chuck Green, perfect. Now, what about Marvel?
So, he wasn't number 2 on my list, but he's up there. Doctor Strange.
Mm-hmm.
I like magic.
Yeah.
And Loki was, of course, magic. I like Doctor Strange getting it thrown in there as well, because
mm-hmm.
I like, you know, how he uses his abilities. We can see a lot more, like, aerial moves with him
mm-hmm.
in a MVC game, so it'd be really cool to see another Doctor Strange, because he was an Infinite, correct?
Yeah,
yeah.
He made his way into Infinite.
He just did not look good in it.
Yeah, that's the thing. Doctor Strange is one of those characters that I feel, for casuals, is not the most pleasant to play. So hopefully if he does make a new appearance, he's a little more casual friendly.
A special three with mirror image and a bunch of rope,
oh, yeah,
fire ropes coming,
yeah,
around.
Yeah, kind of like how he was beating up Thanos.
Yeah,
yeah.
I would love to see that.
That'd be cool. Yeah, that'd be
rip
really
apart
cool.
somebody. That'd be
In
really
fact,
cool.
I'd be perfectly fine if they just ripped it off cut for cut,
yeah,
of him beating up Thanos, but it's just his level 3.
I completely agree. That's why I chose him.
Yeah. Now, do you prefer his comic book design or MCU Benedict Cumberbatch?
I prefer his MCU design without Cumberbatch. Cucumber Patch, excuse me. I appreciate the actor's capabilities and stuff like that. He portrayed Doctor Strange really well. I'm just not a Cucumber Patch fan.
Gotcha.
But I did like the red...
The outfit.
The outfit,
yeah,
he was wearing.
How it looked more realistic. Yeah.
It looked a lot more realistic, a lot more mage-ish and stuff like that. His comic book version looked a lot more superhero spandex.
Like 90s
Yeah. They did make Doctor Strange in the 70s.
Yes, they did. You know. Yeah. Right behind Superman.
But yeah.
And they did do a lot of acid when they made that comic.
Oh, man.
Did they?
Have you seen the Doctor Strange comics from the 70s?
No.
Dude, you gotta see what that stuff looked like, man.
I just remember the four.
That is some mind-blowing artwork for the 70s.
Like, it's super cool, but they had to be on drugs. They had to be.
There is no way they were sober when they came up with that stuff.
Yeah.
I just remember another stun ability that he could have would be to throw his cape.
That would be super
funny. Somebody to grapple him, and he can punch him
That could be his grapple.
The Cloak of Levitation just... Grab somebody.
Just grab somebody. And that's why I chose him. Because I think magic and arcane abilities in MC and DC would be really cool.
No, I think I agree. I think that'd be super dope. Alright, so Francis.
Here we go.
Capcom. What you got?
Another Resident Evil character.
Oh boy. He better be good.
But he's been in the MVC games before. Mm-hmm. Albert Wesker.
Yes.
I was going to say Leon. Oh, my bad. Chris, sorry.
Chrissy.
No. Just Leon again. He takes up two spots.
So, Albert Wesker.
Mr. Wesker.
So, obviously, as you showed me, Wesker has been in the game.
Mm-hmm.
And he does whoop a lot.
Yeah.
And, yeah, I mean, how can you not have Wesker?
Right.
Yeah, he's weak.
Well, obviously, like Infinite didn't have Wesker.
You're talking about video game villains. Wesker's up there.
Yeah,
he has to be. That's another. Agree. I've noticed I've been having a lot of bad guys.
That's okay.
Okay.
We like to be bad. It feels good to be bad. But no, I agree. I think Albert Wesker. Gosh, I can't
Albert Whisper?
No, Whisper. Alberto Wesker?
Albert Careless Whispers. Oh, man. But no, I think Wesker would be a really great choice to add in there. Yeah. I think there's a lot of
great
game.
Aerials and Infinite.
Teleportation.
It's three.
Yeah.
Three is the only one I've played.
That's okay. That's perfectly fine.
And also, as you mentioned, like having Wesker and Leon in a fighting game, it's about a roster. It's not the being like canonically
ignoring the canon and just having fun. I agree. I think we focus too much on trying to make matchups for characters where it's like, well, we need their rival to be in there, where it's like, no, we just need fun characters.
Yeah.
No, I'm cool. I agree with it. Now it's time for Marvel, baby.
It's another repeat character. Deadpool. How
a
can
classic.
You also can't have this guy. Or, I mean, you can't not have this guy.
Yeah. You can't have... I mean, voiced by again, Ryan. they did it in Infinite, but you can't have a Marvel game without Deadpool now.
Especially now, yeah. He's had, like, what, 2 movies?
Yeah.
He did him in the Lego games, man.
From the banter to his fighting style. He's fun to have in a
Ryan Reynolds voiced Deadpool.
Yeah, I was just saying that. I think a Ryan Reynolds voiced in a video game is so fun.
Or, if not, Nolan North is still a fantastic Deadpool, and having him reprise another Deadpool role would be... fantastic.
But if you throw Ryan Reynolds in there, a special move could be Pikachu.
Oh my gosh, you're right!
Or you know what?
Yes, I did have to bring that up.
What he could do is he could put his index fingers on his cheeks and kind of like...
Oh my god!
And he just gets a little static electricity. He goes over and goes...
That would be amazing.
That's funny. That was a great call.
And it'd be a critical hit.
Yeah.
There you go.
He walks away. It's super effective.
No, he goes Thunderbolt when he uses a gun.
Yeah.
Thunderbolt. Oh my god.
He yells Volt Tackle when he does a grab.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
We're
making it right now.
It has to happen with Ryan Reynolds.
That's
right?
Why like Marvel Infinite felt so weird without Deadpool, because like you need to have that funny character that just reminds you that this is a video game.
That was the first game I played with Deadpool, with him going bang bang bang.
Marvel 3?
Yeah,
like that's the thing too. For a lot of people, Marvel 3 is where they learned who Deadpool was, because they're like, he looks cool. Why does he look like a edgy Spider-Man? And then you find out he's way more than an edgy Spider-Man. But no,
he's a
Pikachu.
Well, not
Pikachu.
When I saw is it his level three in MVC 3 where he uses the UI and beats.
He beats you with your super bar and the health bar. It's hilarious. Like, just thinking about Deadpool being in a Marvel game just makes me smile so hard right now.
Good pick.
We
need the classics back.
We need them. Perfect. All right, Santi.
So, speaking of funny characters and classics, Beautiful Joe.
Yes.
You can't just not have Beautiful Joe in there. I may have sucked with Beautiful Joe in MVC 3, but oh my gosh, was he fun to play as. Especially because his hitbox was so small.
It's like playing Yoda in Soul Calibur.
It's not as bad. We'll say that. It's not as bad.
He's so stylish. One of the combos, like the combo names in MVC 3 was called Beautiful.
Yeah. Mm.
He had a signature move. Nice.
Dude, like, if you grew up with a GameCube, you grew up playing Beautiful Joe. So, to not have Beautiful Joe come back as a classic Capcom character, you're robbing us of an experience.
I wish I knew.
You wish you had that experience growing up.
Yeah.
And the other thing, too, is you can even give Beautiful Joe an alternate skin from Dante when he was in the game.
You can.
And it could be a little jab in the game. Oh my gosh.
It'd be so funny.
It's like, where's Dante? Oh wait, I'm right here.
Get the big B.
Yeah. That'd be so funny. Alright, so that's your Capcom. Who's your Marvel?
Taskmaster.
Yes. Whoa.
Queen.
Yes. Wait. Tell us more.
Yes.
Oh my gosh.
Did he play like a Skrull? Super Skrull?
No, it's not that he plays like, I mean, kinda in that he uses a bunch of different abilities from other characters. Like, he has like Hawkeye's arrows, but better.
Okay. But better.
Captain America's shield, but better.
He has the sword, but better.
It's okay.
He's got a sword skin.
It's not Yamato or anything like that, but it's okay.
It's fun.
Taskmaster would be a great person to have in that game, but I'd like to see him.
I mean, he was already in 3. Why not bring him back?
Yeah. And the thing about it, too, is especially with like him being in the Black Widow movie, it's like this is a great opportunity to reintroduce him into the gaming landscape. And just on top of that, it's like when you have all these characters in a fighting game, like we're getting Seth in Street Fighter 5 soon, like literally this week.
Right.
As of recording, we're getting Seth next week. But the thing about it is it's like we need Mimic characters. Because they make the game fun, because they're unpredictable.
Mm-hmm. Like that one from Skullgirls.
Oh my gosh. Second.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
She's fun.
The Inkclaw.
Or was it second, or was it double? It was double. Yeah, her name was Double. Yeah. Like, Mimic characters are just so fun, because they're so unpredictable. So yeah, Taskmaster, I think.
Taskmaster's a great one. That's a great one. All right, Malik, your second Capcom character is...
So, Capcom presents yet another classic character... playing Street Fighter, I never liked playing Ryu. I was a Ken fan diehard for sure, and I want Ken to be the next character that comes in to represent Capcom.
He's a good launch character.
You know, the thing about it is, especially when you look at when we play like Smash Bros, for instance, and it's like, alright, if I'm just gonna goof around and have fun, I play Ken, and when I play Ken, I don't play Ken, I become Ken.
That's like a looking piece of white bread.
Wait, which Ken?
It would have to be...
Five?
No, it'd have to be...
Street Fighter anime Ken.
No, gosh, no.
it
would have to be Third Strike Ken. So Street Fighter 3, Third Strike. It'd have to be that Ken. Just because the fact that it's probably one of the better looking Kens, aside from Smash Bros. Ken.
I mean, Third Strike has some of the best sprites.
It really does. And so it would have to either look like the Street Fighter... Not the Street Fighter, the Smash Brothers Ken. Mm-hmm. or as close to possible. I mean, they're pretty much the same thing as the third strike can. But I just want to be able to scream out, you know, Shinryuba. I want to be able to say Kiku Shinrai Kyaku. I just want to scream these words and these things as I'm doing. I want to keep screaming Tatsumaki Senpukiyaku as I keep kicking people in the air.
He knows it by heart.
He does.
Dude, I'm telling you.
He says it every time before he goes to sleep.
I turn in bed. I just turn to the left and go, Tatsumaki Senpukiyaku. Tatsumaki Senpukiyaku. And it's like, oh, I have to pick up something. It's just Shoryuken. And it's like, I gotta throw something at it. It's like, hey, pass me that ball. Yeah, sure thing. Hadouken!
All right. That's
so,
a good one.
Yeah, yeah, no, it's gotta be Ken. Now, the Marvel, wow. Baby.
I knew it was gonna add baby. I just didn't want to.
Of course. This has gotta be what it needs.
It's Marvel, baby.
It's Marvel.
We're saying that with an H, correct?
Right? Yeah.
Okay. It's Marvel.
That's how it's supposed to be pronounced.
All right. It's Marvel, baby.
So, we said Carnage, but personally, growing up with that MVC 2, I want some Venom.
Oh, Daddy.
I need Daddy.
He needs Daddy.
Long legs.
I need Daddy Black Ink. I need that symbiote. Because the thing for me with, like, growing up with Venom was that playing MVC 2 Venom, he felt like playing with water. Like, he was so fluid. It just felt so good moving around with him. And his abilities were awesome. And then the fact that I found him to come back in Infinite, I was just like, thank the Lord. I don't know what I would have done if I didn't have Venom in Infinite. Because for me, I like playing different characters in fighting games. And if it wasn't for Venom being in Infinite, I would have just kept playing Ultron and Dante over and over again. But him being in there, I was like, you know what? I'm going to play some Spider-Man and some Venom. And it felt like playing MVC 2 Venom again.
I know Francis. That name.
What?
You're a combo of Spider-Man.
Oh, yeah. Francis bared witness to the...
Yeah. He got wrecked before the podcast.
He got wrecked by the slinging combo.
I remember when
every
you discovered that combo.
Yeah, it's a nasty one.
Unfortunately.
Francis is like, I'm going to try
every
Wesker.
Time.
Didn't even know.
Every time.
So,
I think every time you use Spider-Man Venom,
it was
you
just
use
the,
it every time.
It was the
again.
Same combo every time. Yeah.
Gosh.
And it's a basic combo that casuals can learn, and it was just so much fun. And so it's just like having, well, you haven't practiced enough. Yeah, just because you're casual doesn't mean you don't practice.
Sure.
Yeah. But for me, it's just, it's having that classic representation of MVC2 coming back.
Yeah.
And plus the Venom movie. Like,
yeah, oh, it was so good.
Exactly.
It was the only Venom movie I appreciated because he looked like a drug addict the entire time. And I gotta say, he did such a great job.
Wait, when he was losing his mind and he, like, just crawled and jumped into the lobster tank?
Oh, my God.
He 100% looked like he was gonna die the entire movie.
It was amazing.
But here's the thing, though. I don't want that Venom.
No, that's the only Venom I appreciate.
It could be an old skin, you know, how he looked in the movie. But the type of Venom, I want the playful Venom.
Yeah.
I want the Venom that plays with his food before he eats.
His tongue is all over the place.
Yeah, he's slobbering the entire time.
I wouldn't mind that voice actor, though.
Yeah, no, I'm totally, yeah.
Was it Tom?
Well, Tom Hardy played, the voice actor for Venom.
Yeah.
Oh.
How he had that, like, raspy
voice
too.
Yeah.
But the thing is, I kind of don't want that either. Because part of the playful Venom was kind of like how Carnage had a higher pitch. Venom also had that higher pitch, and I kind of want that. I want that,
a higher pitch in the PlayStation.
Did Venom have that?
Yeah, he did.
I
always remember him having a deep voice.
It was like a person with a lot of bass trying to speak at a higher pitch.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like when Malik screams.
Oh man, we gotta talk about
that. Venom is a great choice.
Or when my dad sneezes.
Yes!
If you're listening, you meant it.
But yeah.
If you know, you know.
So that's my round two of Capcom and Marvel. John.
Yes.
Who's your next Capcom pick?
I went with Ox from Breath of Fire.
Alright.
I wanted to go out of the blue with characters, because why not? I didn't know a lot of Capcom characters to begin with.
Especially since, like, none of us know what Breath of Fire is.
Yeah, so Breath of Fire is this role-playing action game. It's sort of played like Final Fantasy, the older Final Fantasy games, where you choose the ability you want to attack with, and they attack with that.
Gotcha.
And it's sort of like Pokemon.
Like your standard turn-based.
Yeah.
Your standard JRPG.
Exactly. And I was looking for big, bulky characters. Mm-hmm. Now, the main character of Breath of Fire is a guy named Ryu. Mm-hmm. Kid,
of
the,
course.
The first game, his name is Ryu. Yeah.
Of course it is.
Of course it is. And he actually, reading about him, had some really cool abilities. He can, like, turn into different kinds of dragons.
Yeah.
And I was just like, that would be a cool character. But then I saw he had other characters standing behind him, and I said, who's the big guy? Mm-hmm. I want to know who the big guy is.
Who's
isn't
that?
It? The big guy behind him was Ox. And Ox is a two-handed melee fighter who can smash people into the ground. And I was just like, that's a Hulk.
So he's Hulk and Nemesis, but with more hair.
And a hammer.
So instead of a rocket launcher,
he's got a hammer. And that just sounds super cool to me. Mm-hmm. And I feel like we don't have enough big characters in video games anymore. Big buff, strange, weird animal characters, to be exact. And he is an ox.
He's like a literal ox.
He's an ox, a literal ox. He's like playing Ganondorf in Smash.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. That two, that
so, like, beast mode Ganon?
Beast mode Ganon.
Okay.
You said Ox, and the first thing that came to mind was just, like, Ox King from Dragon Ball.
I was thinking the same thing, too. I was like, okay.
No.
He's a big boy.
He is. He just doesn't have a lot of hair.
He was pretty hairy.
Ox doesn't have a lot of hair to begin with.
I don't know. I don't study these things.
You're a character designer.
Yeah. That's not the type of character I designed.
Red Chapa. No, I'm sure.
Okay.
But I thought we should have a big character, and I wanted to go random.
Yeah.
And I always like learning about different video games.
Yeah.
And Breath of the Fire, I noticed, was in one of the game sections for the Switch.
Mm-hmm.
The old version of Breath of Fire. Breath of Fire 2 is for the Switch.
Got you.
So we can play it if anybody wants to. If you have the online pass.
Mm-hmm.
And it's on one of those Super Nintendo 64 stuff.
Got you.
Stuff.
The emulator that they have on
the
it.
Emulator stuff. Yeah. And it just came out for it. So
interesting.
Exciting. And yeah, that was my Capcom character.
I mean, I'm glad to have him because, like, kind of like how Terry Bogard was thrown into Smash and everyone was like, who is this old character that no one knows about? It's, you know, it's bringing some of that classic game.
How dare you have some respect?
Yeah. So I like that we're bringing some of that, like, classic before we were born gaming representation. I think that'd be really cool, especially if, like, the next Marvel vs. Capcom is meant to be, like, a celebration.
Yeah.
Kind of like Smash Ultimate, I think. Having
a lot.
MVC Celebration? Did I just hear the name of the next game?
Marvel vs. Capcom Celebration.
Anniversary.
We'll work on the title.
Okay. It's a work in progress.
It's a definite work in progress. Perfect. All right, so.
Yeah, he was just a weird one. My next
Marvel
is Beta Ray Bill.
Yeah.
I want him to look like Thor. Like, entirely.
Except for the horse face.
Yeah, except for the horse
face. Yeah.
He's gotta have the horse face, for sure.
Yeah.
But I want him with the wing helmet, mm-hmm. the old classic Thor looking.
Yeah.
And
the super campy design.
Yeah. And then the axe hammer. Ugh.
Man, the original Stormbreaker felt amazing to see in action.
It was so cool.
So
Beta Ray Bill needs to come in. We need to drop Thor.
And
we need Beta Ray Bill in. Well, because no one knows who Beta Ray Bill is anymore.
We have hashtag Kit Chris. I don't know if we can have a hashtag Kit Thor.
I think Thor is important.
You know what?
It applies for both.
You know what? It's hashtag
Chris Hemsworth.
So hashtag Kit Chris. So we've got hashtag Kit Chris. We have hashtag Throw Thor.
Why do I keep starting these? I don't mean to.
Yeah, you know what? It'd be like that sometimes.
But I appreciate it. When I was making this list, I put Thor, and then I thought real hard about it. I said, no, we don't need another Thor. What about Beta Ray Bill?
Especially since they referenced him in Ragnarok, and Thor Ragnarok. Or at least they referenced his race. It's like, you can't be teasing us like this and not give us more. In fact, I'm hoping that with the new Thor movie, we get at least like another reference, or
they're
to see Beta Ray.
Probably going to bring him for as Guardians of the Galaxy.
That's a strong maybe, but it's a possibility.
It's not bad.
But you know what? If we can't get him in the movies, I agree.
I mean,
let's get him in Marvel.
Taskmaster and the other Russian guy, I forget his name, for Black Widow.
I can't think of this red something, but I know who you're talking about.
Red Skull?
No.
Yeah, that's way different.
There's a different person. But yeah, no, I mean,
I don't know what I was
thinking. If we don't get him in the movies, let's get him in the game.
Yeah.
I agree.
All right, yeah. All right.
Perfect. All right, Francis.
Okay. I'm going Mega Man here.
Okay.
So,
but the question is, which one?
Mega Man X.
Okay, there you go. Okay. Now we're sticking to something
that on
like.
PSP was the best.
I actually didn't pick Mega Man, I picked Helio.
Uh-huh. But you switched to Mega Man.
No.
Or are you just thinking with Helio?
Yeah, Helio.
Why?
I don't know.
You hyped us with X and then you switched it on us.
I don't know Mega Man. I'm gonna be honest, I don't know that much about Mega
I'm gonna Man. Kill Alien and swap out. I'm gonna veto this. Okay. Alien's gone. We're putting in X.
You go ahead.
No. We all know who the real Mega Man character we need is.
Proto Man.
Mighty Number 9.
Wow, it is a dead silence. I was insane there for a second. Hold on.
Oh, let's not. Your jokes.
So now I'm going to say there's the door just because.
His alt skin can be the 4-hour long credits.
Salty. Leave. But yeah, no, I think X would be a way better representation than Alia, only because
people
would freak
shade.
Out. Like, people would scream to see X again in a fighting game.
But I mean, because I was thinking, like, X would be, like, too well-known already. I mean, maybe.
There's nothing wrong with that, though.
But if you're bringing back classics like Deadpool, you gotta bring Mega Man.
You gotta bring X in. Yeah.
And make him X, because we had the child Mega Man last game.
Child Mega Man was in 2.
Okay.
We got I think it was actually X in Infinite.
Okay.
And then we got Zero as well.
Which wasn't a bad choice. Zero was
disagree.
Yeah, Mega Man wasn't even in 3. It was just the other one.
Proto Man.
No. It was Mega Man. Yeah. No, it was Zero. You're right. Zero was in 3. And the thing for me is it's like
they did Zero wrong.
The thing is with Zero is Zero's cool if you're one of those like kids who grew up edgy and like Sasuke when you came to Naruto. Like you're like, yeah, I like Zero because his name sounds really cool. But if you're gonna talk about legacy, especially if the concept we're trying to roll with is like a celebration of Marvel and Capcom, then I think X would be a stronger choice.
Okay. He's a major supporting character.
I know what she looks like, and I know who she is, and I can tell you right now in a fighting game, no one's gonna care.
Okay.
Yeah. No one. I mean, there are gonna be people who will care, but then they're gonna be like, why do we get Alien, not X?
Seeing more supporting characters come out of the Infinity, I like that's my show.
But she can come in as one of his specials though, so she could be like a level 3 support special, where she like buffs him,
or she's like an intro.
Or something, yeah, where she kind of is just like walking in with him or something like that, yeah. So that way she's getting represented.
Yeah.
But yeah, we don't need to be afraid of characters that are well known, because that's the whole thing is characters we know sells. That's just the plain truth. Okay. That's kind of the reason why Marvel Infinite was kind of a big mess, is because the characters we knew weren't present. But, alright. So we got some Mega Man X representation, but what about your Marvel representation? How it's supposed to be pronounced.
Okay.
You will pronounce it correctly. We live in a nation, in a society, where we say it Marvel.
Oh, he just said the Joker.
It's Marvel, baby.
We live in a society.
Abomination.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm kind of shocked, too.
Yeah.
Why not?
Well, I'm not saying no.
I don't think Abomination right when I think Marvel. That's why I was
not against it.
No, I'm not against it. I was just shocked.
I just want to know why.
He's a rival against Hulk.
Yeah.
Okay.
We need a big guy.
Yeah.
Against
another bad guy.
Okay.
I mean, Red Hulk.
Yeah, I would love a Red Hulk. But I mean, Abomination is a classic.
That's true.
You know, that would be a really big twist, too, if they were just like, instead of, they tease us with, kind of like how Smash teases you with, like, oh, you thought it was going to be this character, but it's actually this character. It's like, oh, you thought you were getting Abomination, but actually, it's Red Hulk. But no, I think Abomination would be cool. I think the only sad thing about Abomination is he's kind of become more and more obscure to the mainstream because of how poorly he was treated in the Incredible Hulk.
What
about comics?
I've not been seeing much from him out of the comics either. But you know what? That doesn't mean that it can't change. And like I said, I'm not against it, but
it's just interesting. Just get him away from on the right track.
Oh god. I'm gonna quit my job. But cool. Alright, so Santi, Capcom. What you got?
Alright, for this pick I went with Amaterasu from Okami.
Of course, you have to bring in that classic.
Which is, it's such an old classic game that even the HD remake they did of it looks like, wow, yeah. It's so really old!
But the question would be, would you keep Amaterasu still being the same from 3 and just basically like copy and paste her?
Amaterasu 3 is a dog. but I guess like technically a woman. But I would appreciate them making Amaterasu a little more casual friendly, because Amaterasu and 3 is just different to play.
You just need to get good and suck less.
That's not gonna happen anytime soon. That's not gonna happen anytime soon, let me tell you that. So just, if they could make Amaterasu a little more friendly, or casual friendly, mm-hmm. that would be great, because I love her design in 3.
Got you. Now, what about Marvel?
For Marvel, I picked Miss Marvel.
Whoa,
now that surprised me.
Here's a question though. Which one?
Oh, we already know which one.
Not to be confused with Captain Marvel.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. We're talking Miss Marvel.
Yeah, I thought that should be clarified on the podcast because a lot of people are like, oh yeah, Captain Marvel is Miss Marvel.
And it's like, no, there's a difference. Yeah.
Miss Marvel is the spit.
You're talking about comic book black spandex Miss Marvel, right?
Yeah.
Stretchy Marvel.
What? No. Wow. You're thinking of Kamala Khan, Miss Marvel.
Yes, that's who I thought he was talking
No,
about.
You're talking about classic Carol.
I'm talking about classic like, Miss Marvel.
Yeah. Oh, Carol Danvers from back in the day.
Got it.
I mean, I also wouldn't be mad against with the new.
Yeah, let's be honest.
So, Kamala Khan, Carol Danvers, either one would be pretty cool.
Either one, as long as it's a Miss Marvel.
Yeah, okay.
In fact, you know what? For the sake of the change that's been happening with the characters, I think Kamala Khan would probably be a better Miss Marvel. I mean, hey.
That way we can drop, you know, Mr. Fantastic if he's on the list, you know?
Exactly. Yeah. You know, just
we
saying.
We don't need a Fantastic Four in this game.
just throwing it out there. But I think it's really cool because the fact that we're bringing a really well-loved new character. Because at first when they announced that Kamala Khan was going to become a Ms. Marvel character, I was like, I don't know how people are going to react to that. And surprisingly, people love her. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, cool.
She's a really good character.
I didn't
character.
Mean to change that up on you. I'm so
no,
sorry.
I'm glad
I mean, obviously, I'm glad you did. Because, like, I'd be happy with, like, any Miss Marvel. But, if they're going to bring in Miles Morales.
We got to bring in Kamala Khan. Yeah.
I just appreciate her.
Especially because they'll probably still keep Captain Marvel in there anyway.
Yeah. Exactly, yeah. We can still have Carol Danvers and Kamala Khan. They can be separate characters. But I think if we had to define one specific Ms. Marvel that we're going to have, I think Kamala Khan isn't a bad choice.
I got to agree with that.
Yeah.
Okay, I apologize.
You're thinking outside of our nostalgia box, and I love it. Because we were just like, yeah, Carol Danvers back in the day when she got her power stolen by Rogue. But no, I like that. Kamala Khan, it's a really good idea. And not a lot of people talk about her so much in the mainstream. So I'm hoping that within like the MCU in the future, we can start to see her a little bit more.
And she's not a Captain Marvel.
No.
She's
so
Miss Marvel.
That's where the difference lies. Because Captain Marvel is Carol Danvers now.
Yeah.
Because she passed Ms. Marvel on to Kamala Khan.
Got it.
Yeah. Especially because, I don't know if you guys know this, but the Avengers game that got pushed back, the one that got delayed.
Yeah, I'm so glad it did.
She's the main character.
Yes!
Yeah, Kamala Khan's actually the main, which it was kind of hinted at when you started to hear the voice narrating in the first trailer. You're like, this is a random female voice. Why are we listening to a random female voice talking about idolizing heroes? Oh my god, it's probably going to be Kamala Khan. I have no idea.
I'm going
to
look that up.
Yeah.
Love voice actors.
But no, that's cool. Yeah, so switching it up to Kamala Khan, Miss Marvel, instead of Carol Danvers. I like it. I think it'd be cool. So now, for my Capcom pick, I had to bring in yet another classic. One that I wasn't very used to playing with a lot, but I started having a lot more fun with him as of recent, and that's Strider Hiryu.
Yeah.
Strider Hiryu has just been such an iconic aspect of Marvel vs. Capcom for me. And it goes down to even the most basic of sound design. Like, just hearing Strider use his moves sounds so cool. He's a ninja. You're playing a ninja in a fighting game. He's fast, he's slick, he summons animals made of robotic parts to come attack you. He's just cool. He's the definition of, like, I grew up in the early 2000s, cool. So to have him in another Marvel game, I think would be fantastic. The fact that we were able to have him in pretty much every iteration of Marvel from 2 till Infinite is a really good sign.
Yeah.
So, hey, if you're going to keep him going for that long, why are you not going to have him in the new game? That's all I got to say.
It's another classic.
Exactly, he's just another classic. Especially because they came out with the new Strider game, and it was super cool looking. Like, I really want to sit down and play that game, because it looked fantastic.
I remember they came out with the new Strider game.
Yeah, it looks really good. So, you may have to check it out one of these days.
Well, what about your...
How dare you?
It's Marvel, baby!
How dare you? You casual noob, you uncultured swine.
We've done it all night.
I think what you meant to say was, who's my Marvel character?
John, like you said to me earlier.
Yeah.
There's the door.
We're just passing it around.
Yep.
For my Marvel, because, you know, we have to sound somewhat professional, he's my favorite superhero of all time. And
you mean Winter Soldier.
You're hilarious.
Yes.
God, you're...
Oh, I know who you're talking about now.
John, who am I talking about?
C-3PO.
Oh, God. My friends don't know who I am.
Oh, he's talking about Iron Man.
Yes, I'm talking about Iron Man, you silly goose. Yes. Oh, my gosh. Another classic Marvel versus Capcom character.
He is beautiful.
We gotta have...
Even going back as far as Marvel versus Street Fighter.
We gotta have that proton cannon.
Yeah.
I need that cannon. I need my Unibeam, man.
Oh, Unibeam! Unibeam against Malik Unibeam. Is the scariest thing, because you know he's going to spam it.
No. Santi's dad is the one who spams
Spams Unibeam.
But for
it's
me,
really annoying.
playing Iron Man is kind of just living my dream, because it's just like, he feels strong. He feels powerful when you walk around, when you're flying around. And honestly, it's just, I just want another excuse to play more Iron Man, man.
Yeah.
Like, a lot of people where I grew up, with my generation, with our generation, they were all Spider-Man fans. And I actually grew up not liking Spider-Man. And I think I've said this before on podcast, but I grew up not liking Spider-Man.
I remember.
I was an Iron Man fan through and through. He's always been my favorite hero. He will always remain my favorite hero. Even when he turned evil, he still became my favorite hero. I was like, yes, I like this. And they put the superior Iron Man suit in Infinite, and I was just like, I'm sold.
I was about to say, what kind of suit would you like to see?
I want to see the superior Iron Man suit in all
just superior.
I mean, it's his villain suit, but I kind of want to see it. But I mean, as far as hero suits, I don't care.
I'd like to see the classic, like, old, like, TV show Iron
Man.
Oh,
yeah.
That
like,
gold,
that gold super clunky bullet, gold the, everything.
He looked like a bullet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
like, those can... Alt skins, dude.
Alt skins.
I'll pay for that.
I would like to see an alt skin that has his old reactor from the first Iron Man that got turned into like memorial proof that Tony Stark
has
a heart.
Yeah.
I would love to see that as part of his old skin.
That would be cool. Or even just like, I would like to, so here's the actual like fever dream, is I would like Iron Man as a character, but he's Tony Stark. So instead of going full Iron Man suit, when he punches, it's like the nanotechnology becomes the Iron Man parts.
Oh,
yeah.
That'd be cool.
And so he punches and goes,
he's got
bink.
Like boots on, so he
can
do aerials.
And so then when he wants to like do his supers, then he summons the entire suit.
Oh, that'd be
and
cool.
Then it's like he just beats people down, fires his torpedoes and all that. Like, that would
that's
be so
the,
sick.
That's the name.
You're embarrassing me in front of the wizards.
It'd just be so cool.
That would be cool. I would also, if they don't do that, if that isn't a thing, it'd be cool to see battle damage with him.
Yeah.
And the nanites being
taken
away.
Yeah.
Okay, can
that
we,
would be cool.
The combo he did against Thanos right before he got stabbed, can we have that combo
That's
in
what
the
I'm
game?
Saying. That'd like, cool. we need Endgame / Infinity War Iron Man nano suit. Like, that would be really cool. So, that's...
Yeah.
We that's gotta
good.
Have that.
That's good, yeah. He's a classic and he should come back.
Exactly. Always. All right, so, John.
Yes.
Capcom.
Capcom presents. I'm going to go to the strange one. I like learning about new games, so I'm going to go with Captain Commando.
That's, you know, that's a classic.
I
was a classic in 2.
He is in 2.
Yeah.
And I heard he was really good by my friend here, Malik.
Oh, yeah.
He said that Captain Commando was actually kind of fun to play.
He was very fun to play.
And I'd like to see my space pop.
Yes.
Just a little bit more. And I love learning about new games. I learned a lot about that game.
Yeah.
I really want to play it again.
And again, it's connecting those classics. It's a celebration of Marvel and Capcom.
And I want to see classics coming back. So Ox and, you know, Captain Commando.
Bring in those retros.
Yes.
All right. Now, what about your Marvel?
I'm going to go another strange one.
Okay.
And I'm going to go with the Heimdall.
Oh,
Heimdall.
That's a good choice.
Heimdall from, you know, the Greek.
Greek? You mean the Norse?
No, I mean the Greek. No, I'm just joking. Yeah, Norse mythology.
Yeah.
I as much as I liked MCU Heimdall.
Are you going to tell me that you don't want Idris
Elba
in Heimdall?
No, I want him in it.
Okay, I was about to say.
No, I want him.
Yeah.
I want him to look like it, but like act like, you know, the story-wise Heimdall.
Gotcha.
He was a watcher, just like he was in the movies.
Mm-hmm.
But in the movies, he was... You know, he ran away from his position and stuff like that. He died in his position in the stories.
Yeah.
In Norse mythology, he died for it. And just, you know, I like the sword character, so seeing him with a sword
would be super cool.
It would be super cool. And
just,
if he,
his level 3 is him just summoning the Bifrost.
Yeah, and like, just taking him away in space, and then beats him up and sends him back down.
Or just continuously, it's like Portal, where you're just going through a portal back and forth.
That'd be cool.
So it's just like he beams you up, drops you down, beams you up, drops you down, and then he just goes in for the slice.
And with the gold eyes would make it amazing. He would be my arbiter in a way.
That could be his thing, like, he like comes in. And he's just like, I am all sea. Sink! Oh, man.
I'd love to see Heimdall in a game.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
I think that'd be really dope. And I think they killed him off way too soon.
Yeah, so let him live on in the game.
Yeah, man. Bring him in the game.
All right. Francis, Capcom presents.
I'm pretty sure there's a throwback. Astaroth from Ghosts and Goblins.
I was thinking that, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was thinking about Astaroth.
He's another bad guy.
Mm-hmm.
I have been having a lot of bad guys.
It's okay. We know who you are.
We know who you are.
No comment. Okay, so... Yeah. All right.
I mean, the fact that he's a big guy...
He looks cool.
Yeah, he looks cool. A 3D version.
I mean, what else do I have to say?
And plus, he also kind of was shown in 3... as a background character for one of the stages.
He was.
Yeah, he was.
Wow.
For 3 base and for 3 ultimate.
Yeah, I gotta play this game.
Like, I was doing some research because I don't know that much Capcom stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So he has some nice moves. I'm gonna admit, he'd be good in a fighting game, I think.
So, yeah, I mean, it'd be really interesting. Yeah. And also, again, classic characters that not a lot of people know about.
Bring it back to people's, like, knowledge.
Exactly.
Let them be knowledge.
Yeah. Like, if we're gonna have Arthur in all these previous mob games, we need to get some Astaroth in there.
Yeah, I agree.
And at least he looks good.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. He looks like he'd be a cool character. So, what about Marvel?
I like this one. Nightcrawler?
Yeah! Now, are we gonna go with like. Are we gonna go with like the movie, all he does is teleport and use his tail, or are we gonna go with like a swashbuckler Nightcrawler?
I'm actually kind of conflicted on that one, because I played one of the. You know those movie video games?
Yeah.
And then.
It was like a side scroll?
No.
It was like the Link.
It was
the
on...
movie. The
oh,
game.
Okay.
Yeah.
It was on PS2. I think it was called X-Men Last Stand. Or was that the movie?
Last Stand was the movie, but yeah, you're talking about like the game.
There was a movie.
Or the movie that had Nightcrawler.
Jeez, I forgot which game that was.
Or even just Nightcrawler.
Or Game Ultimate Alliance.
Yeah, or even, yeah.
But yeah, in that game, fighting as Nightcrawler was so OP.
Mm-hmm.
Beating up all the henchmen and stuff, teleporting around.
Yeah.
Especially teleporting to travel.
Mm-hmm.
That was so nice.
Yeah, and I mean, I asked about the swashbuckler one because A, you bring in another character with a sword,
mm-hmm.
but B, it allows him to do a lot more cool animations where he kind of like grabs the rapier with his tail and just starts like slashing you with that.
A lot of range.
He's like bamfing around and he's like swiping you with his tail as he bamps.
That'd be really cool. Nice. Good choice.
Yeah, that was a
really
good
choice.
So is that the teleportation sound effect, bamf?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So they call it bamfing.
It's
not teleporting.
So when you
Because the thing for him with teleporting is it's not that he's going from location to location. It actually is he's going into a pocket dimension.
Yeah, he's a stereo
and then the pocket dimension that he's at, it has like the smell of brimstone. And so when he teleports, it's like imploding. Yeah.
It's limbo.
Basically, exactly.
Yeah,
he's the embodiment of Limbo itself. So yeah, that's why they call it vamping, and I thought that would be cool. And that's why in Marvel 3, so here's some little Marvel 3 trivia. When Deadpool teleports and he like uses his belt to teleport back and forth, he's saying bam. Like he says it out loud, he goes bam. And that's what he's doing when he's teleporting.
Great.
So that's super funny. Been perfect. Alright.
Sachi.
So some more DMC love here.
Mm-hmm.
Your daddy Virgil.
Of course.
All right.
Of course. But why?
Because he's Nero's daddy. You can't just have. You can't put Nero in there and not have Virgil.
Sure, you can.
He just threw his character, and he's all like, "Yeah, everybody's gonna agree with this."
And I mean, you're not wrong, but there are gonna be a lot of people who probably won't agree with you.
But also, I love as much as I suck with Virgil in 3. He's so much fun to play.
He is.
And yes, like, his character design is so good.
Yeah. Now, one thing I would say with Virgil, if he is to be in the game, he should use more devil, like, devil weapons like Dante did.
His ult can be V.
That would be really funny, where he kind of just, like, stabs himself, turns into V, and then just...
That could be his three, where he slips himself with Yamato, yeah. And then it's a combo attack with the V and Yurizen.
And Yurizen. That would be so cool! Oh my god!
That would be awesome.
That would look so cinematically sick. Oh my gosh. But I mean, you're right. It's Virgil. Enough said.
Exactly.
Perfect.
I shouldn't have had to explain myself.
Hey, we need to get the watch type somehow. Alright, so that's Capcom Presents, but what about Marvel?
Alright, that's another classic. Can't not have Jean Grey.
I mean, you kind of can.
Well, you're wrong.
I mean, did you see how she ruined Marvel 3? You kind of can.
I mean, okay.
Comments are saying
she was pretty broken in Marvel 3.
Was pretty broken.
Is pretty broken. Well, that's besides the point. Okay, Jean Grey is an X-Men classic.
This is true. No, you're not wrong. All right, so we get that. Marvel Girl.
Gotta have the Phoenix.
Gotta have the Phoenix in there. Oh man, I'm afraid to see how she breaks the game this time around.
Just literally, her three is shutting down your system.
Yeah, she's yeah. She can see Infinity Gauntlet out of nowhere and just goes, that's it, your game's done.
Yeah, PC just alt F4.
That's cool. But talking about one classic female character to the next, for my Capcom pick, I felt like my world was kind of torn when I didn't get to see Senko in Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite. So the thing for me is, it's like, I really like how Senko has this like toolkit to her. That's her whole thing. I really like the backstory of her and how it kind of plays into the culture that she comes from and just like how they're represented. It's basically like their version of zombies.
That's a Japanese zombie.
Yeah, it's basically Japanese zombies.
I forget the actual
zombies.
Name for it.
I gotta try to remember it too. But it's like, it's just super cool. And just like her like idol animation was always something that like I was like, this is super cool.
She's always fun to play.
She's fun to play as, she's fun to look at, and it's Senko. Like, she's super cool. And so I definitely want her to come in as my Capcom pick. But for my Marvel pick, I gotta take it back again to Marvel 2 and bring back some Cyclops.
Our second.
I was actually thinking of that one.
I need more Cyclops. Because the thing for me is, it's like, I don't really like playing with zoning characters who use a lot of projectiles. I'm a very, like, fist-to-fist, face-to-face kind of person.
I can
when you got
can
your hands on
this.
Cyclops.
Except for when I got my hands on Cyclops. Oh,
I,
man.
I can suggest that you only use them sort
of. Oh, yeah. No, like.
Punchy characters, because I'm the only gun guy in this
game. I mean, you've seen me play Tekken. I love me some Leroy Smith. I love that hand-to-hand, feet-to-feet. But
except
for
when
me,
you play Noctis.
Shut up. We don't talk about that. But when it comes to Cyclops, the thing that's cool about it is, even in Marvel 2, he has a really cool, like, close quarters combat combo. And he has his, you know, his beam that he's able to fire. So being able to kind of mix that up, use it as an assist and things like that. And also, you can't really talk about representing the X-Men without Cyclops. Like, yeah, you got Wolverine, but if you're going to have your Jean Grey, we gonna need to have that Cyclops too.
No, his bae.
His
I mean,
boo.
The love triangle must be
or
complete.
Or her, yeah. We
with
have to all oh my god.
Yeah.
Oh man.
Oh, so Wolverine.
That's it right there.
Gosh. Let's not talk about their love triangle, because technically it's like I don't go there.
Let's not go there.
I don't go there. But yeah, so we gotta bring some Cyclops in there.
Good choice.
We gotta get some more X-Men
great
in there.
Choice. Great choice.
So yeah, Cyclops for
yes.
sure. Now, John. We're coming along to the end.
Yes.
Who's your final Capcom character?
I like
you.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Regina from Dino Crisis? Is it?
Oh, wait.
You're looking at
Were you looking at the wrong one?
I'm looking at the wrong one.
The wrong character. But no, so we got some Dino Crisis representation, again, with that classic celebration.
Yeah, and that's why I chose her. I was just like, you know, she's an older character in the game that we haven't seen in many years.
Yeah.
And I would like to see another Dino Crisis. I have not played a Dino Crisis.
There might be a chance that we might be actually getting a Dino Crisis soon.
Really?
Yeah.
Don't tease me with a good time.
Trademarks
don't
and licenses.
Do that. Don't give me hope.
Don't give me hope.
I'm just saying. You
I
never
hate
know.
Saying.
So, we'll see.
Yeah. So definitely Vegeta for Final Crisis. Mm-hmm. I'd like to see another Gen character, and she would ultimately have a shotgun. So yeah. That'd be super.
Hey, any character with a shotgun, I got you.
I was about to say.
Yeah. Yeah. You got
close quarters, please.
Yeah. Perfect. All right, and then your Marvel character. Now I'm excited for this one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now who's your Marvel character?
Mysterio.
Yeah, there you go. That's what I was talking about.
I saw that Santi, Santi said, let's go with, Miles Morales Spider-Man.
Yeah.
And I was just like, all right, let's go with another Spider-Man villain.
Mm-hmm.
And Mysterio is one of my favorites.
He's so good because
he's got fishbowl. Ice fishbowl. That is so cool. Like, oh my gosh, and the entrances he could have.
Yeah.
And most of my characters have been mostly magic-based at this point, but
I don't care.
He would be such a good rival for Doctor Strange and Spider-Man and Loki.
Okay, do you want his comic book designs or his MCU design?
Comic book design.
I agree. Yeah.
I don't want to see his MCU design.
I agree.
Only because we never really got to see it. We saw mocap.
It's a little too realistic, and it's not comic booky enough.
I mean, they did keep the fishbowl, which I can appreciate.
They did, and...
He was wearing the fishbowl in the final fight. Yeah. I agree with that.
Now, that's what I wanted to talk about, though.
Yeah.
His level 3. Being the illusion he pulls.
Oh, yeah, the drones? Oh, that would be
just,
cool.
He just calls in the drones, and they do that ultimate illusion thing.
But comic book Mysterio was never drone-based, was he?
He wasn't, but...
What?
Who's to say you can't merge
the
illusion
sequence in Far From Home?
That was so cool. Good.
Yeah, that was awesome how he was fighting back and forth with drones. Drone. That was dope.
And I'm not even talking about that. Let's take it a step further, where he traumatized Peter Parker with the illusions.
In the bar?
It was when they had the fake warehouse set up.
Oh, that was dope. That'd be a great
illusion.
That would be so great.
That's what I mean by the drones. I'm not talking about that final fight with the drones. I'm talking he just creates this mass illusion.
That's just awesome.
When he gets Peter Parker when he hits him with the train, he
turns into a giant.
Yeah. Just, oh my gosh.
That would be awesome.
Would probably be the coolest, because you're talking about a character who could potentially have one of the coolest looking finisher moves of all fighting game history, and it would make sense that it would look super cool.
Yes, I agree. I definitely agree. And I think a little teaser to the MCU for an intro for him to walk in with, he's, in the mocap scene.
Yeah.
That would be kind of cool.
That would be and then he kind of just
he becomes Mysterio, and you fight as Mysterio from the comic book, and I think that would be really dope.
I agree.
I'm really glad I chose him for my last.
Just
the smoke and the helmet and the cape. Give it to me.
Awesome. All right, Francis.
Okay, so arrival of beautiful Joe Alistair for Capcom.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Bringing in that rival game in.
Mm.
But the question is,
why?
Another bad guy. And okay, like I said, I don't know that much about Capcom games, but he has a nice aesthetic, so.
Yeah.
I mean, it would be cool to have some representation from Beautiful Joe.
I agree.
And, I like his motive of seeking the ultimate battle. I think it'd be fitting.
That makes sense. You're in a Marvel vs. Capcom game. You found the ultimate battle. Yeah. So, you found Marvel, baby.
Yeah.
Gonna take you for a ride.
That's a great choice.
I agree. But now, your Marvel character.
So, I actually just learned about this, about a week ago.
Mm-hmm.
Asylum?
Yeah. Which is interesting, because not a lot of people, and by not a lot of people, I mean 99% of people who would ever hear this don't know who that is.
I'm gonna raise my hand to that. Explain who this character is, please.
He was a mutant in youth. He's been rejected. His parents were drug addicts or something.
Mm-hmm. Like most mutants are.
Okay.
Wow.
You didn't have to say that. Jeez.
No.
Shot through the heart.
And then eventually ends up getting control of something called Dark Force.
Yeah.
And then it feeds off of dark feelings, darkness and despair. So basically in Mortal Kombat, he's Noob Saibot.
Yeah.
Oh.
And then I like that.
No, I approve.
I think that'd be really cool.
Noob Saibot was really cool
I even saw a comic image of him, and he looks like he could be a Noob Saibot. Yeah.
No, I think that would be cool.
And I think bringing a character that no one knows about into a video game to bring awareness to him would be a really good idea.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that is a great choice for him.
Perfect.
Exploration.
Yeah.
So, Santi, your final Capcom character. All who's right. gonna be?
He presents one of the faces of most Capcom.
Yeah.
Ryu for Street Fighter.
It's pronounced Ryu. Is what your father would say. That's exactly what your dad would say.
Did you just feel the slap upside your head? Because that's what happened.
I did.
Yeah. But
like,
no.
I am not my father. How dare you? But like, you can't just not have Ryu.
Exactly.
Put Ryu and Ken in there.
So, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, hey, if they could put Ryu and Ken in Marvel 2,
then rival.
Why can't we have them in the new Marvel game? I feel it. It's one of those enough says.
And also, Evil Ryu alt skin would be nice.
Oh my gosh, yes! Give me some of that Satsui no Hado. Oh man, especially if we're not gonna get like an Akuma, like giving Ryu that Evil Ryu skin, or even being able to like alternate between if he's using his good power and his like negative power, I think would be a really cool aspect. So, I think that's really cool. And plus, bringing back a classic.
Yeah!
You got stiff. But, what about Marvel, baby.
Oh boy. It's Marvel, baby. Oh, Iceman.
Oh, yes.
Oh, like Spider-Man, Iceman?
I guess he was part of Spider-Man.
He was the Super Friends.
I'd like to see Cube Man again, yes. Ice
oh my
Cube.
Gosh.
Yeah, he was a...
No.
He's Iceman, he's really fun to
we're
play
not talking
as.
Cool, everybody drinks.
We talking Marvel 2 Iceman.
Wow.
That his freaking giant ice ball that goes from a close quarters move into his own.
Yeah.
Which is so stupid, though.
But it's so much fun. Yeah, no. We got Iceman. It was probably one of the funnest nights of Marvel 2 that we've ever had.
Nice.
When we figured out some of his combos, and then just like we kept using Iceman on each other.
Yeah. It was a very, very stale fight because of the fact that we just kept using the same dude over and over again.
You're like, I know what you're gonna do. Stop it.
Stop it. Yeah.
But you can.
Fear it. Run from it. Iceman will come all the same. But no, that's cool. And you know what? We're bringing in more mutants.
Yeah,
and I like it. We're showing that we want mutants in a Marvel game.
We're going to have quite a few X-Men.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, that's we missed them.
Yeah.
We want them back.
Yeah, and as gamers, I bet we're going to protect them. These are the characters we want.
Are these some of the characters we want?
They have X-Men now for the MCU.
Exactly.
So.
Give us Iceman. Give us the X-Men.
It's a good time. It's part of the bringing them in process.
Exactly. And in fact, you know it. Even if you don't want to do a Marvel versus Capcom, give us a new X-Men versus Street Fighter.
There you go.
You won't. Cowards. Speaking of Street Fighter, my final Capcom character, I had to save the best for last.
Yes.
And the thing is, it's probably not a surprise to anyone who knows me and
Capcom. Step on me!
Yeah! Well, if you didn't get that from Santi's reference... I want Juri Han.
Bring him.
I need my queen to be in Marvel, baby.
Yeah.
I need my kicking queen to be in this game. If I have to explain why I want Juri Han in Marvel, go watch our last podcast. Right, yeah. Hear me gush about this character, and you'll know why I want Juri Han in Marvel. That's all I gotta say. I ain't saying no more. Bring me my queen.
Step on him.
Step on me.
He was actually on my list, and then I crossed him out because I was just like, I shouldn't do this.
You'd better not
my
girl.
I listened to the last podcast, and I said, no, I shouldn't do
you
this.
You better not steal Juri Han.
I can't do this.
Will step on you.
Because I want to see him too. I really do.
Her.
I'm sorry.
You will not deface my queen. I need Juri Han. But... she's not the only queen that I need to return to a fighting game.
Yes.
Now, once upon a time, there was a character with a nice southern accent that everybody used to love, and they should still love to this day.
Talking about that.
I need Rogue to come back to Marvel.
They did her so dirty in the original X-Men trilogy.
They need to fix her. They need to heal her. They need to bring her back.
I miss her.
Rogue used to be such an important character in Marvel, and everyone used to love her.
And she's so cool in MCU.
She's super cool. And here's the thing. If you've ever played Dragon Ball FighterZ, you've played a character called Android 21 who can take people's powers away, or not take them away, but at least
turn them
copy
them.
Yeah, she could copy their powers and use it against them. For Street Fighter V, with Seth doing the same thing, we're getting mimic characters. Like I said earlier, we need more mimic characters. Give me,
you gotta
Rogue.
Throw people off their rhythm with a mimic character.
Exactly. And Rogue was the original mimic fighter.
Yeah.
Like, when it comes to stealing, like, Android 21, man, Arc System Works looked over, and they saw Rogue, and they were like, let's do that, but with an Android. And it was fun. People liked it. Give us Rogue back, or at least give us another character that could do something that Rogue did. I'll take either one. So
Rogue's a good character.
That's okay. That's mine.
All right. What character design for Rogue?
Remember the TV show?
I want to go with the X-Men animated series, Southern accent Rogue.
I want short hair Rogue.
No, I need me some long hair Rogue.
With the headband.
Yeah.
I need some
long hair Rogue. I need some classic. Kind of like how with Ms. Marvel we were thinking like the classic black spandex. Like, I need that.
I need some
Rogue.
Southern iced tea up in here.
I need my Southern iced tea.
Bring it.
So, guys, that's 40 characters.
Woo!
We just spewed off 40 potential characters for a Marvel vs. Capcom game.
But wait.
There's more! Because it wouldn't be a fighting game without DLC. So
I want the first one.
All right, so John's going off. He's coming with heat. What's our first DLC character?
Oh, never mind.
Okay, all right, fine. I'll take our Capcom representative.
Yes, do it.
So our first, actually no. It's not right of me to do this.
No.
Francis.
Take it away.
You should tell us, who is our first DLC character?
You guys treat me too well.
Yes, we love you.
Monster Hunter!
Yes!
Give it to us. Give it to us now.
I'm gonna admit, I didn't play with Monster Hunter much in
not
the
yet.
Game.
Not yet. You haven't yet.
You didn't know it was there.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. But yeah, I like the ability. You could do like the switching ability.
The switching weapons.
Yeah.
Alright. Her armor is pretty insane.
Her armor is intense and infinite.
And then they could have a bunch of other alternate armor.
Exactly.
There's a lot more costume designs.
There's a
precisely.
Lot.
You could give her some of the special edition like other Capcom
the
game armors.
Yeah. We need some Monster Hunter.
An intro with, you know,
her riding in with Rathalos. That would be cool. Her intro is just her riding in on Rathalos, and she just hops off. And she's just like, you can go now. I'm gonna rough you up. And you're just like, did this dwarven just ride in on a dragon?
And the dragon left. Yeah. I'm scared of her.
The true dragon.
Or, you know, if people think that that's too much, then she can just ride in on a winged drake. That's cool too, I guess.
With the grappling hook?
Yeah. So she's just flying in. She just drops. She's like, time for the hunt.
Yep.
And it's like, all right. I can see.
I'm more intimidated by both.
Yep.
And the behemoth armor set.
Yeah. Oh, don't tease me.
That would be fantasy.
I don't know if it'll work. Because it's a Square Enix thing, but it's so cool. Oh man!
I approve.
All right, so that's our Capcom.
Yes.
John wants to handle our first Marvel representative. Who's our first Marvel DLC?
Squirrel Girl.
Of course.
Yes.
Sandy Cheeks,
man.
And there's his third game crush.
Gosh, you're exposing me too much today, Santi. I can't have this. No.
We need his top three.
We need Squirrel Girl. We need the ultimate Marvel character in the entire world.
We need the strongest Marvel character of all time.
Yes. I want her to have squirrels that go into Iron Man's suit to peel away at his skin. I want to see wires ripped apart Ultron's character.
Squirrel Girl is the only character that gets fatalities.
Yes.
There you go.
I will put Squirrel Girl in any game that I want, and I want her in this one.
Perfect. All right. Now, bringing it back to Capcom, this one's mine.
Yes.
This is me.
Oh, this is the one I was talking about. Right?
Now, we got Deadpool, and he's a funny dude, and he's a silly character. But we need a joke character. We need a person who is just trying so...
Buddy, I love you with all my heart.
That felt bad.
Okay, bud.
That felt really bad.
At least I wasn't the diversity hire.
That's true.
I got freckles, hold on.
Ladies.
Does the beard not hide the white?
I love you both equally, but not as much as I love Dan Hibiki. Man, you want to have a joke character who's actually fun to play?
He better.
Dan is that character. I'm so sad we don't have Dan in Street Fighter V.
He's a joke character in every game he's in.
But he does it so good.
Even in the Street Fighter Puzzle Arcade, he's the joke character, and his thing is just all one solid color.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. And the thing for me, this is what I need. I need him to bring back that wimpy Hadouken.
Yes.
Where he tries
You showed that to me today, and I lost my mind.
It's so funny.
Every character with a Hadouken. It was adorable.
It was the cutest thing ever. It hits.
Yes.
But it's like, you ain't hitting nothing unless you touch in their face.
Yeah.
And I also thought that in Marvel 2... he's trying.
He's trying.
But I thought in Marvel 2 it was really cool that he had like a Johnny Cage signature type thing.
Oh, and he threw the card.
And he throws the... Yeah, he throws his signature. I was just like, that's pretty funny.
And what would be really cool is if you teamed him up with Deadpool to say a game.
Yeah.
They take a selfie together.
That would be funny. That would be so funny. His level 3 would be him trying to do like all the mainstay Street Fighter moves. So he's like trying to do like a Shinryuken and he misses. He tries to do a Hadouken and misses. He tries a Shoryuken and he sucks. And he's just like, ugh. So he throws his hands up and accidentally hits the character and just knocks them out. Like,
he takes the health bar and just dials it out.
And just, takes it out. Like, Mysterio would have the coolest looking finisher.
Yeah.
But Dan would have the funniest finisher.
Man.
I think that would be awesome.
Dan is nice.
So now going from Capcom, right, but we, you know, we had to kind of pop him out, bring like DLC. I think he'd be a really cool DLC.
Yeah.
Now going over to Marvel, you want to take this one, Santi?
I mean, I'm probably the last one.
All right.
You want to do the last one?
I mean, he was the one that brought it up.
I get the very last one.
No, he brought it up.
I want the last Capcom.
How about you guys say?
Oh, most definitely.
All right, I'll go with this one.
All right.
All right. Kingpin.
Yes!
Give us another Spider-Man villain.
But I want, like, bulky.
Yeah.
Oh, you mean, like, square?
Round, I want thick square Kingpin.
Oh, man, he's thick!
I want him walking in with, like, Daredevil holding his, like, skull. Like, I don't know.
I want him not holding his skull, but holding his mask. Like,
yes!
He's just like, I've taken out the devil, I'll take you out too.
That would be cool.
Like, when I saw Kingpin into the Spider-Verse, I was like, now that's Kingpin.
I think of a mob boss, I think of Kingpin.
It's like,
Spider-Verse.
That's a man. I think it's just really cool too, because if you give Kingpin armor, it like technically makes sense because he's not fat.
Yeah.
He's big, but it's all muscle. And you're just like, oh, wow, that's a man.
When Kingpin sits in a room, he is the room.
He is the room.
He takes up half the screen.
Yeah.
I would enjoy that.
Oh my god. Alright, so you got the Marvel one, but you wanted the Capcom one too. Who's going to be our final Capcom DLC character?
The diversity, the Mexican, and Marvel's Capcom, Amingo.
Yeah! Our Lord and Savior, who died on the cross for our sins. Amingo.
Well, like even his blocking animation MC2 is the best.
It's so great.
Because instead of actually blocking, he puffs out his chest, puts his hands on his hips, and just takes it.
He takes it like a champ.
Oh boy. Spikes come out like
pimples. It's wow. Oh my.
There's the button.
But yeah, I remember when we first saw him blocking and he just tanked it. I was just like, this character is the greatest thing I've ever seen since sliced bread. This is so good.
And then he'll like just pop down mini cactuses and they just walk at you and they stab you.
And you could probably throw in a Monster Hunter joke and have him throw those guys out.
Oh my gosh, the Gachalakas. Yes. That would be so funny.
That'd be
a great crossover. Oh man. Or you could have Monster Hunter like picking at him and then he kinda like pops up, he's like, what are you doing?
Like, hey.
Oh my gosh, that would be super funny. Alright, so our final DLC character and a character who I've grown to love more and more, and thanks to watching the streamer Maximilian Dude with his Assist Me series.
Finger lasers!
Oh my gosh, we need to have Dr. Doom. And like Santi said, we need the finger lasers! Oh my gosh, Dr. Doom was so cool. Like, you talked about how like Kingpin entered a room, he sat in that room and he was the room.
Yeah.
When Dr. Doom sat on his throne, This entire world is his. The game of Marvel is his. When he slams that hand down, he's telling every character, I am Doom. I don't just rule Latveria. I rule Marvel, baby.
Oh, man. When he took Silver Surfer's powers?
Dude. Or when he became, like, the new Iron Man. Like, he could have that as a... Oh, give me some Doom. I want to give infinite Doom.
Secret Wars.
Like, Doom is just... He's a character.
I'd love to see him.
And the thing about it, too, is that we're getting some more of that Fantastic Four representation.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because it's like, sure, you can have all the Fantastic Four, but I don't care about them as much as I care about Dr. Victor Von Doom. I want that Latverian leader to come in and bring Doom to all the members of Marvel. I love all the other characters.
Yeah.
But the finger lasers. I just want it back. So yeah, that right there. That's 46 characters. We just helped you out, Capcom and Marvel.
We made it easy for you. Now all you really have to do
is just make the game.
Fund it.
Just make the game.
Just do the game development and do the marketing.
If you need help, call me.
Do the publishing.
If you need help with designs, I got you.
We did it. We did the hard stuff for you guys.
You just gotta fund it. Yeah. Just make it.
Yes.
And that's the whole big thing about this is
we are the fans.
If for any reason you somehow survived and made it to the end of this video, please share this. Make this go viral. Because the thing is, everyone talks about their dream Marvel list. But we want to make sure that our suggestions, our voices get thrown into that pot. Because at the end of the day, whether you're a big Marvel fan or not, you cannot deny how good it feels to play a good Marvel game. It's just how it is. And since Marvel's going to be at EVO, and there's a chance that one of us might actually be going there, we might actually be able to see if there's a live reaction to some news that might be coming in July.
All I know, Marvel Capcom, you're welcome for this list. We better see executive producer for Gauntlet Games.
Yeah, yeah, I agree with that.
Oh, man.
Being a name.
But yeah, so before we go, do any of you have anything else to leave the audience with?
I do have one thing.
What's good?
It's Marvel, baby!
That was the closer.
Did you not read the script?
Oh my gosh. I am the last word.
It's not perfectly balanced anymore. Like all things should be.
Yo. Oh boy. It was taking so much to hold it back. I thought he wasn't going to say it because
my
of references.
Oh boy.
Man.
No. I just wanted to bait.
That was beautiful.
Well, with that being said, this has been the Gauntlet of Gaming. These hands are rated E for everyone. My name is Malik.
My name is Juan.
Francis.
My name is John.
Yes.
And ladies and gentlemen, it's Marvel, baby!